4, Charlie Yankee Foxtrot, right base 35, touch and go Bathurst.
Radio calls at non-towered aerodromes are broadcasts. We have to remember when we're flying into non-controlled aerodromes that there can be a wide variety of traffic, VFR, IFR, RPT, helicopters, single-engine, multi-engine aeroplanes, light sports aircraft. And so the purpose of calls at a non-controlled aerodrome is to help traffic see and avoid each other. So we have to remember that underlying principle. They should be broadcasts of our intentions. We should keep them short and to the point and use the impair format or the format in the AIP wherever possible.
Bathurst traffic, Charlie Yankee Foxtrot going around runway 35 Bathurst.
I like to use, to keep me on track for standard radio calls, is impair, I-M-P-A-I-R. So I is ident, to whom am I talking? Me is the make of the aircraft and my identification.
Bathurst traffic, Charlie Yankee Foxtrot, Cessna 172 is now.
P is position, and position is always either a location or distance and bearing from a location.
Is now 8 miles to the north.
The A is altitude.
To the north at 4,000 inbound and estimating. The circuit area at Ryleston at time 22.
Last of all, the I is intent. It's very confusing when people mix up their intentions and what they're going to do in the middle of all of that other information. And there we are waiting to know, but please tell me, how many miles away are you? Intent comes at the end, and then the last R at the end of the word impair is for the rest. Anything else, a request, a report, any other information that you need to deal with. So, applying that to an arrival at a non-towered aerodrome, 10 nautical mile boundary, it would be Bathurst traffic, Cessna 172, Charlie Yankee Foxtrot, 10 miles south, 4,500, inbound, circuit estimate, time 26, Bathurst traffic. The horizontal dimensions of a CTAF, or the vicinity around a non-controlled aerodrome, is defined by 10 nautical miles either side. Vertically, it's defined by a height at which we would potentially conflict with traffic at that aerodrome, so that's a pilot judgment decision. When arriving at the 10 nautical mile boundary, aircraft should make known its intention to either transit that zone or to enter that zone for the purpose of landing. Arriving at the circuit area, aircraft should broadcast their joining the circuit and making it clear on which leg of the circuit they are joining.
Bathurst traffic and rec 6564, Charlie Yankee Foxtrot, upwind runway 35, touch and go Bathurst. And break Bathurst traffic, Charlie Yankee Foxtrot going around 35.
We should make sufficient radio calls to allow others to know where we are and for safety, but not so many that we clutter the airwaves and cause an unsafe situation. When we are taxiing or about to enter the runway or take off, we should broadcast those intentions.
Yankee Foxtrot taxi, runway 35 for circuits, Bathurst.
And as we are departing the aerodrome, we should broadcast our departure from the aerodrome and then the CTAF, stating clearly the nature of our departure so that traffic knows where to look for us.